Greetings, friends, and welcome to this week's online healing devotion. Listen to the following scripture. While he was in one of the cities, there came a man full of leprosy. When he saw Jesus, he fell on his face and begged him, "Lord, if you will, you can make me clean." Jesus stretched out his hand and touched him and said, "I will be clean." Immediately, the leprosy left. We read this in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 5, verses 12 to 13. If we look back at ancient Judaism, we see that sin and disease were understood as being closely related. Sin and disease. In the story of the man born blind, for example, the disciples asked Jesus, "Who sinned, this man or his parents, that he should be born blind?" Jesus goes on to dispute the logic behind this question. In any event, one of the evident reasons that disease was closely associated with sin in the ancient context has to do with the idea of ritual purity. Now, there were a variety of things which could render somebody impure or unclean, ritually unclean. Amongst these things were bodily fluids. This has to do with the notion, which is prevalent in most religions where there is strict social control and behavioral boundaries, that bodily fluid belongs on the inside of the body, not on the outside. So as soon as you find bodily fluid on the outside of the body, it's deemed out of place and therefore risks ritual impurity. So to have an open wound, or to have a lesion, or to have a continuous flow of blood, in the context of ancient Judaism, renders somebody unclean or impure. Now what is worse, if this is not bad enough, not only does it render someone unclean or impure, which could be remedied by the participation of this individual in a ritual cleansing to restore one's ritual purity, but if the sore or the lesion or the flow of blood is permanent, then it renders somebody or it forces somebody into a state of permanent ritual impurity or uncleanness. We see this, as already mentioned, in the woman with the flow of blood in Mark chapter 5 and in the reading that we've just heard from Luke chapter 5 in the case of people with leprosy. Of course, their lesions are permanent, they do not go away, they render the leprous person force them into a state of permanent ritual impurity. No matter how many rituals of purification are performed, the permanent lesion, essentially the permanent presence of bodily fluid outside the body, renders the person unclean. So, in addition to existing in the state of uncleanness, ritual impurity, this also renders somebody sinful, makes them sinful, forces them into a state of sinfulness. Because ritual uncleanness cuts off your relationship with God in the context of ancient life. In addition to this, if you are in contact with such a person, you yourself risk ritual uncleanness or ritual impurity. So not only in the case of the woman with the flow of blood, or in the case of leprous people, are you in a state of ritual impurity, in a state of sinfulness, but also you become socially shunned and isolated because nobody wants to touch you, nobody wants to socialize with you, nobody wants to interact with you because they know that if they do, they themselves will risk becoming ritually impure and potentially sinful. And so we see how in ancient contexts, one's physical health has a bearing on one's psychological and social well-being and vice versa. Now finally, in conclusion, when we read that Jesus touches the leper in Luke chapter 5, the passage that we read at the beginning, Jesus is not simply transferring a magical healing power that he possesses to the leper, but he is communicating something at a deeply profound level. As a rabbi, he is communicating to the leper, who has probably for much of his life been shunned and isolated by the rest of the community, communicating to that person God's love, God's grace, and God's acceptance. On that note, let us pray. God of healing, God of love, God of wholeness, God of peace and consolation, today we bring before you all within our community who are ill or experiencing suffering of any kind, whether in body, mind, or spirit. We bring before you not only those who are sick, but those who are lonely, isolated, marginalized, or stigmatized for any reason. We know, Lord Jesus, that you cured by your touch, which convey not only your healing power, but most especially your unconditional love and acceptance of that person. So we ask you, Lord, to help those who are experiencing anguish in body or in mind, that they would know this love at a very deep and profound level. May they thereby come to know the fullness of your salvation. We ask for